ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಶುಭೋದಯ. ಜಿಲ್ಲಾ ವ್ಯಾಪಿ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರ ಅನುಭವಾತ್ಮಕ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ತರಬೇತಿ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ 2020-21 ಆಂಗ್ಲ ಬೋಧಿಸುವ ಪ್ರಾಥಮಿಕ ಶಾಲಾ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರಿಗೆ 18 ಜನವರಿಯಿಂದ 22 ಜನವರಿ 2021 ವರೆಗೆ ನಡೆಯುತ್ತಿರುವ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದ ಉದ್ಘಾಟನೆ ಸಮಾರಂಭಕ್ಕೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಸ್ವಾಗತ. ಮೊದಲಿಗೆ ನೋಡಲ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್, ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ತರಬೇತಿಗಳ ಓವರ್ ಆಲ್ ಇನ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಆಗಿರುವಂತ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ಭಾರತಿ ಮೇಡಮ್, ಹಿರಿಯ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸಕರು ಡಯಟ್ ರಾಮನಗರ ಇವರಿಂದ ಸ್ವಾಗತ ನುಡಿ.
ಸ್ವಾಗತ, ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಸುಸ್ವಾಗತ. ಈ ದಿನದ ಈ ಆಂಗ್ಲ ಭಾಷೆ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ತರಬೇತಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಮಿತ್ರರನ್ನ ಬರಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ತ ಈ ದಿನದ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರೋತ್ಸಾಹವನ್ನ ಕೊಡ್ತಿರುವಂತಹ ನಮ್ಮ ಜಿಲ್ಲಾ ಪಂಚಾಯತ್ ರಾಮನಗರದ ಕಾರ್ಯನಿರ್ವಾಹಕ ಅಧಿಕಾರಿಗಳಾದಂತಹ ಶ್ರೀಯುತ ಇಕ್ರಮ್ ಸರ್ ಅವರಿಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಪರವಾಗಿ ನಾನು ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕವಾದ ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನ ಬಯಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಹಾಗೇನೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಉಪನಿರ್ದೇಶಕರು ಆಡಳಿತ ಮತ್ತು ಉಪನಿರ್ದೇಶಕರು ಅಭಿವೃದ್ಧಿ ಇರೋರು ಸಹ ನಮಗೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನ ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶನವನ್ನ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರಿಗೂ ಸಹ ನಾನು ಈ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕವಾಗಿ ನಮ್ಮ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನ ಕೋರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ನಂತರ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದ ತಾಂತ್ರಿಕ ಒಂದು ಸಹಾಯಕರಾಗಿ ಕಾರ್ಯವನ್ನು ನಿರ್ವಹಿಸ್ತಾ ಇರುವಂತಹ CWC ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಯ COO ಆಗಿರುವಂತಹ ರಾಜೀವ್ ಅನ್ನಲೂರ್ ಅವರು ಕೂಡ ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವ್ರಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ನಾನು ನಮ್ಮ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಪರವಾಗಿ CWC ಪರವಾಗಿ ಅವರನ್ನ ತುಂಬ ಹೃದಯದಿಂದ ಸ್ವಾಗತಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಲ್ ಅಧಿಕಾರಿಯಾಗಿ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ಚಂದ್ರಿಕಾರವರು, ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸಕರು ಡಯಟ್ ರಾಮನಗರ್ ಅವರು ಸಹ ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು 3 ದಿನಗಳ ಕಾಲ ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗಿಗಳಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಸಹ ನಾನು ನಮ್ಮ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಪರವಾಗಿ ತುಂಬ ಹೃದಯದ ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನ ಕೋರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಹಾಗೆಯೇ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದ ಪೂರ್ಣ ಪ್ರಮಾಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಸಂಪನ್ಮೂಲ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳು ಹಾಜರಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಮ್ಮ ಡಯಟ್ ಇಲಾಖೆ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ಉಮಾ GHPS ಕೋಡಹಳ್ಳಿ ಕನಕಪುರ, ಹಾಗೂ ನಳಿನಿ ಎನ್ GHPS ಬಾಲಗಿರಿ ರಾಮನಗರ, ಇವರಿಬ್ರು ಕೂಡ ನಮ್ಮ ಇಲಾಖೆ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಸಂಪನ್ಮೂಲ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳಾಗಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇವರಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ತುಂಬ ಹೃದಯದ ಸ್ವಾಗತ. ಹಾಗೆಯೇ CWC ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಇಬ್ಬರು ಸಂಪನ್ಮೂಲ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳು ಭಾಗವಹಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಕೃತಿ ಸತೀಶ್ ಮತ್ತು ಸುಶೀಲ್ ಕುಮಾರ್ ಸಿಂಗ್. ಇವರಿಬ್ಬರನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ತುಂಬ ಹೃದಯದಿಂದ ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನ ಕೋರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಹಾಗೆಯೇ ಈ ಒಂದು ಸುಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಆಂಗ್ಲ ಭಾಷೆಯ ತರಬೇತಿಯನ್ನು ಪಡೆಯುತ್ತಿರುವಂತಹ ಸಮಸ್ತ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ನಾನು ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನ ಕೋರ್ತಾ ನನ್ನ ಸ್ವಾಗತ ಭಾಷಣವನ್ನು ಮುಗಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಧನ್ಯವಾದ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಮೇಡಮ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್. ಸೊ ಈಗ ಪ್ರೀತಿಯ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ನ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡೋಕೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಈ ದಿನದ ಸಂಪನ್ಮೂಲ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳು ತಯಾರಿ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಬನ್ನಿ, ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ.
The topics for today's webinar are tenses, prepositions, articles, and subject-verb agreement. Good morning, all. ನಾನು ವೆಬಿನಾರ್ ಈಗ ಶುರುವಾಗಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮೊದಲು ನಮ್ಮ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಬರುವ ಒಂದು 4 ಚೆಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಡ್ತೇನೆ. ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ವುಡ್ ಬಿ, ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ವಿಷಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವೀಗ 4 ವಿಷಯಗಳನ್ನು ಏನು ನೋಡಿದ್ವಿ, ಆ ಪ್ರತಿ 4 ವಿಷಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ನೋ. ಈ ಚೆಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಆ ವಿಷಯದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಆ ವಿಷಯದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಚರ್ಚೆಯನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಆ ವಿಷಯ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಅದನ್ನ ಅದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅರ್ಥಕೋತೀವಿ. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಬಂದು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಐಡಿಯಾಸ್, ಆ ಒಂದು ವಿಷಯದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವೇನ್ ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ಇಷ್ಟೊತ್ತು, ಅದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ರೂಮ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಯಾವ ತರ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ಬಹುದು, ಯಾವುದು ಬೆಟರ್ ವೇಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ಬಹುದು, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ವೇಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ಬಹುದು ಅಂತ ವಿಭಿನ್ನ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಮೂರನೇ ಚೆಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟು ವಾಟ್ ಡಿಡ್ ವಿ ಲರ್ನ್. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಮಾತಾಡಿದ ವಿಷಯದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಸಮರೈಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ನಾವೇನೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾತಾಡಿದೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಮೆಲುಕು ಹಾಕಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅನ್ನ ಗಟ್ಟಿ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತೀವಿ. ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಬಂದು ಫನ್ ವಿತ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್. ಸೊ ಫನ್ ವಿತ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಮಾತಾಡಿದ ವಿಷಯ ಅನ್ನ ಆಧಾರದ ಮೇಲೆ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಅದನ್ನ ಬಿಟ್ಟಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಭಾಷೆ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಗೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ರೆಡಲ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಅಥವಾ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಗೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಆಟ ಆಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಜಂಪ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅವರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸಿಂಗ್ ಅವರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್. ಯೆಸ್ಟರ್ಡೇ ಇಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ, ಟುಮಾರೋ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ, ಬಟ್ ಟುಡೇ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಗಿಫ್ಟ್, ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್. ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಎವ್ರಿವನ್ ಅಗೇನ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸುಶೀಲ್ ಕುಮಾರ್ ಸಿಂಗ್. ಐ ವಿಶ್ ಟು ಪಾಸ್ ಈಚ್ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈ ಲೈಫ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ಫುಲ್ಲಿ. ಐ ಲಿವ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಬಟ್ ಐ ಲವ್ ದ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್, ಐ ಲವ್ ದ ನೊಸ್ಟಾಲ್ಜಿಯಾ. ಐ ಲೈಕ್ ರೆಮಿನಿಸಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್, ದಿಸ್ ಫಿಲ್ಸ್ ಮೀ ವಿತ್ ಪ್ಲೆಜರ್. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅ ಪ್ಲಾನರ್. All this reminiscing helps me to plan for things that the future holds. When I am remembering and reminiscing about the time that has passed, it is in the past tense. When I talk about today, it is in the present tense. And when I plan and prepare for the future, it is in the future tense. I am a teacher traveler, and I am here in search of interesting and unique activities that I can take back to my classroom to transact to my lovely learners. But to do that, I need to get past these locked doors. One of these doors will lead me to the world of activities, but I do not have the key to any of these doors. So first, we need the key. And the key is what is with one of these three doorkeepers. To get the key from them, we need to talk to them. But there's something peculiar about them. Let's ask a couple of questions and understand what is peculiar in them, and then also try to guess who might actually have the key. Let me start by asking this question. What is your name?
My name was Past Man.
My name is Present Man.
My name will be Future Man.
Interesting responses from them. Okay, let me see. Will you help me?
I had helped you. I am helping you.
I will help you.
They surely talk in a peculiar manner. Let me just ask them who has the key then. Do you have the key? Oh, what is this? I can't see their responses. My dear teacher participants, can you all imagine how they might have answered? If you guys have imagined their answers, then you people already know who actually has the key. Help me to know who actually has the key. Many of our teacher participants have selected the present door guard as the person who should have the key. Come on then, let's see if he really has the key. Present door man, do you have the key? Yes, he does have the key. Very good. So let me open the door and get into the world of activities.
Welcome to the world of activities.
Are, who are you?
I am the genie of tenses. How may I help you?
Hi, genie of tenses. Nice to meet you. I am a teacher traveler who is in search of interesting activities to teach tenses. Do you know any interesting activities to teach tenses?
Yes, sure. I have many ideas to transact tenses. Come, let me show you. This is a suggested idea which the learner would enjoy in playing in the classroom and learn about tenses at the same time. You start by creating a grid on the board like this. On the top, we have a bunch of pronouns. To the left, we have a bunch of verbal phrases. Dear teacher traveler, would you like to choose a cell in the grid?
You want me to choose a cell? Okay. Then I'll choose. Let me select this cell.
Okay. Say, what corresponding pronoun and verbal phrase you got?
The corresponding pronoun is she, and meet friends is the verbal phrase that I've got.
Will you make a sentence which is in past tense using your pronoun and verbal phrase?
Sure, Jeannie. Let me try. Using she and meet friends, the past tense sentence could be she met friends.
Good. Very nice. The same steps can be repeated for three tenses as present tense round, past tense round, or future tense round.
Oh, interesting.
Sushil, I have something for you.
What is that, Jeannie?
This is a tense band that you can wear.
Tense band? What is a tense band?
The tense band is nothing but a roll of paper wrapped around the wrist of a player, like any wristband. This band has three icons on it, each representing the three tenses. The first button represents past tense. The middle button represents present tense. And the last button represents future tense. Sushil, rotate the band to arrive at any of the three tenses. And okay. Tell me, which tense did you arrive at?
Sure. I am rotating the band now. I think I arrived at present tense.
Okay, present tense. Like this, you can use these bands to play the game that we played previously using the same grid. Like this, learners can be engaged in making up their personalized tense bands within the classroom to bring out their creativity.
Interesting activity, Jeannie.
Sushil, I have another interesting game for you. Roll and choose, pick and change. Here, the players roll the dice, which has the names of the three tenses on its each side. The fourth side will have the words roll again. The learners roll this dice and consider the tense depending on what side the dice rolls facing up. Then the learners pick any sentence from the ice cream sticks and try to change those sentences into that tense. The activity blends in the kinesthetics of rolling the dice and choosing the tense, and visuals of choosing the sentences from the colorful ice cream sticks. Sushil, now you take the dice and roll once.
Okay, Jeannie. I just rolled the dice and I arrived at future tense.
Okay, then I will give you a sentence. Ibrahim performed on stage. Did you change the sentence into future tense?
Okay. Ibrahim performed on stage. Huh. If I have to change this to future tense, that would be Ibrahim will perform on stage.
Sure.
Thank you.
Sushil, do you like jumping games?
Jumping games? Yes, I do like jumping games.
Then now let's jump to tenses. This is a classroom activity which utilizes kinesthetic approach of learning, where learners listen to commands or directions given in English and respond using their bodily movements. The participants start by standing on the line drawn. The line represents the present tense. The area in front of the line would be the future tense, and the area behind the line would be the area of past tense. The teacher starts by reading a sentence. If the participant thinks the sentence is in future tense, then he or she jumps forward into the future tense area. If the sentence turns out to be in past tense, then the participants jump behind the line into the past tense area. Did you like the game?
Yes, Jeannie. This is very creative. My learners always want to hop around the classroom. This can be an interesting game for them. In fact, I'm going to take all these activities back to my classroom and to my students.
Let us now consolidate our learning on tenses. We know that every event happens in either of the three tenses broadly. If an event has already happened, it belongs to the past tense. And we use words like did, was, had, etc. to refer to it. When an event is still in process and is still going on, we refer to it in present tense with words like is, going, having, etc. And if an event is yet to commence and yet to happen, we refer to it in future tense and use words like will, shall, could, etc. Jeannie, now we have reached our checkpoint of fun. Would you like to solve a riddle for me?
Yes, I like. Let me try, Kriti.
Sure, Jeannie. Here is your riddle. It says, I have three letters, but pronounced as one letter. I am double, I am single. I am black, blue, and gray. I'm a part of your body and I'm the first thing that people see in you. What am I?
Kriti, I am unable to solve this riddle. So let me call my friend, the genie of prepositions, to help me solve this riddle. My friend, genie of prepositions, please help me to solve this riddle.
Let me try, Kriti, but I need options.
Sure, Jeannie. Here is your options.
Sorry, I'm unable to solve this riddle. Can somebody help?
Sure, Jeannie. Let us ask our teacher friends to help you out. I guess by now they have already guessed the right answer.
Kriti, 100% of our teacher friends have told answers. That is I. Is it the right answer?
Yes, Jeannie, it is the right answer.
Can you tell me how it is the right answer?
Jeannie, eyes can be black and some eyes are blue and brown as well. The letters in the word I are three, but we have only one pronunciation of I. Therefore, the answer is I.
Wow, very interesting, Kriti. Hey, Kriti, even I also have some interesting thing to show you. Would you like to see?
Sure, Jeannie.
Come, let me take you to the room of prepositions. Prepositions are the words that tell us or inform us about the position of the objects. Like here, prepositions help us convey that things are kept on the bed, some things are kept on the floor, but beside the shelves. Some things are on the wall and some things are on the table. Now, Kriti, can you tell me where is my cap?
Jeannie, your cap is on the shelf.
What about my phone?
Your phone is on the table, Jeannie.
Good, Kriti. Come. Let me show you some interesting activities. While we are going towards the activities, let us follow the cat to understand the basic proportion. Above, on, in, under, below, and beside. Kriti, what can you see here?
Jeannie, I can see some basic shapes like rectangle, circle, triangle, etc.
Yeah, you are right, Kriti. Now, it is time to take that paper and that pen that you have had kept ready because it is sketching time. Follow my instructions, listen to my sentences, and follow them to complete the sketch.
Sure, Jeannie. I would also request our participants to do sketching with me since they have already kept the paper and the pen ready with them.
Let's start. Get ready for the first instruction. Now, let's start by drawing a triangle in the middle of the page. Let's start by drawing a triangle in the middle of the page. Next, draw a small circle inside the triangle. Draw a small circle inside the triangle. Then we have to draw a square below the triangle as big as the triangle itself. Draw a square below the triangle as big as the triangle itself. Then draw a vertical rectangle inside the square on the base of the square. Draw a vertical rectangle inside the square on the base of the square. Next, draw two identical curved lines beside each other below the square. Draw two identical curved lines beside each other below the square. I hope your sketching is over.
Yes, Jeannie.
Kriti, can you show me?
This is my sketch, Jeannie.
Yeah, very good, Kriti. This is the sketch I wanted. Looks like you have followed my instructions properly.
Thank you, Jeannie.
Now, I want you all to draw another sketch. Take a fresh page. Start by drawing a large circle in the middle of the page. Start by drawing a large circle in the middle of the page. Then, draw a medium-sized inverted triangle over the top of the circle, but one of its corners must be inside the circle and the other two corners must be on the outside. Draw a medium-sized inverted triangle over the top of the circle, but one of its corner must be inside the circle and the other two corners must be on the outside. Then draw two small circles beside each other inside the triangle. Draw two small circles beside each other inside the triangle. Then we have to draw two medium sized circles on the upper two corners of the triangle. Draw two medium sized circles on the upper two corners of the triangle. Then draw two small straight lines on either side of the large circle. Draw two small straight lines on either side of the large circle. Next, we have to draw two more small parallel straight lines on the bottom of the large circle. Two more small parallel straight lines on the bottom of the large circle. That concludes second sketch. Have you finished, Kriti?
Yes, Jeannie.
Can you see some of the words in yellow color?
Do you mean in, top, inside, outside, beside, bottom?
Yes, Kriti. They are nothing but prepositions. Now, Nalini, can you show me your sketch?
Yes, Jeannie. This is my sketch. I got bad rat.
Excellent. It looks like you have followed my instructions properly. Kriti, now show your sketch.
Jeannie, I also got a rat, but my rat has become lazy, so it is sleeping.
Oh, looks like you haven't followed my instructions properly, Kriti.
Sorry, Jeannie. I actually got confused with prepositions. Next time I will definitely look into it and draw a proper sketch.
Sure, Kriti.
Jeannie, before that, I have a question. What if my classroom has students with different need? How do I teach them preposition?
Kriti, as a teacher and a facilitator, it becomes responsibility to prepare activities with everyone in mind and everyone's learning in mind. So here you can use wooden or cardboard cutout of shapes which visually challenged learners can touch and see and identify the shapes and follow the same instructions and carry out the activity with everyone else and just like everyone else. Alternatively, sandpapers can be used to cut out the mentioned shapes, which will provide a good tactile feel to the learners, who can then touch the surface and the edges, identify the shape, and play with prepositions.
That was a very creative idea, Sushil and Jeannie. Thank you for helping me out.
We have used prepositions to identify the location of a new object. Now, let us look at a new idea which can be played as a group or a team. This can be played in a classroom with all the students participating in it. Kriti.
Now, yes, Jeannie.
I want you to follow my instructions and draw accordingly.
Sure, Jeannie.
Let me start by drawing a fish bowl in the center of the board. Now, make sure the fish bowl is on the table. The fish bowl is on the table. When I say this, all you have to do is draw a table on the board and make the fish bowl sit on it. Next, make sure there are fishes in fish bowl. The table is between two chairs. There is a panda behind the table and a cat is under the table.
I have finished drawing, Jeannie.
Kriti, what do you see here?
Jeannie, this looks like a train.
Train. Yeah, Kriti. This is propulsion train. Here, you start from the first compartment of the train. You roll the dice and move along the different compartments by solving one question at a time. Each box has a question regarding the proportions of place. For example, if I say, I like to sit dash Sahana, what would be your answer, Kriti?
I would say, I like to sit beside Sahana. Am I correct, Jeannie?
Yes, you are correct, Kriti. I like to sit beside Sahana. Then, move on to rolling your dice and then answer to the question that is there. This activity can also be carried out on the classroom floor by drawing series of boxes to bring some kinesthetic element to this game. The learners can also hop through the boxes just like in Kunte Bille game.
That's a very interesting idea, Jeannie.
Priti, you just imagine you have won a jackpot and you can buy anything that wish to. What would you purchase?
I would wish to purchase some jewelry, then a mobile, tablet, and a laptop. Then probably a scooter and some home appliances, Jeannie.
Oh, very nice, Kriti. If you buy this, where will you keep laptop, Kriti?
Jeannie, I would keep my laptop on the table in my house.
And what about fridge?
I think I will place fridge in the kitchen next to the shelf.
Kriti, where will you keep your jewelry?
Jeannie, that's a secret. I will never reveal it to you or to anyone.
Okay, Kriti. Just like this, an image of a room can be displayed to the learners, and then they will take turn in placing each of their objects somewhere in the room or the house. Kriti.
Yes, Jeannie.
Now, I want to purchase few toys, but I can't find them here. Can you help me to find the toys?
Sure, Jeannie, I can.
The first toy in my list is wooden horse. Can you find it for me?
Wooden horse. Yeah, it is right here, Jeannie.
Where, Kriti?
Jeannie, it's right there. See?
Where? Can you please show me the proper position?
Proper position. How will I tell you the proper position? Friends, I need your help. I don't know how to tell a proper position of the wooden horse. I can only say that the wooden horse is dash the paint canvas. Can you help me fill the blank? Jeannie, my friends have helped me out to tell you the proper preposition. The wooden horse is behind the paint canvas. Can you see it here?
Yeah, Kriti.
See, it's now, right here.
Now I found it, Kriti. The wooden horse behind the paint canvas. Thank you, Kriti. And next, the second toy in my list is toy truck. Can you find it for me?
Sure, Jeannie. Toy truck. Jeannie, I found it. It is right here.
Where?
It is right here, Jeannie.
Can you tell me the proper position of the toy truck?
The toy truck position. No, one second. Wait, let me ask my friend's help. Dear friends, please help me out for this one last time to tell the proper preposition to convey to the genie. The toy truck is dash the conveyor belt. Thank you, friends. Thank you for helping me out. Jeannie, my friends have helped me out to tell you the proper position of the toy truck. They have told me that the toy truck is under the conveyor belt. Can you see it here?
Where, Kriti?
See, it's right here.
Now I found it, Kriti. The toy truck is
under the conveyor belt.
Yeah, the toy truck is under the conveyor belt. Thank you, Kriti. And one more toy is in my list. Can you find it for me?
Sure, Jeannie. What is it?
That is dartboard.
Dartboard. Jeannie, I found it. But I also know that you want to know the proper position of that dartboard. But I have already asked so much of help from my friends. I don't want to trouble them more. So, I think I know what preposition I can use it here. The dartboard is in front of the sketch of the bear. Can you see it here?
Where, Kriti? Where?
Right here, Jeannie.
Ha, Kriti. Now I found it. The dartboard is in front of the sketch of the bear.
Yes, Jeannie.
Thank you so much, Kriti.
You're welcome, Jeannie.
Kriti, now the time for homework.
What is the homework, Jeannie? Jeannie, I think I know what homework you were supposed to give me. You just wanted to tell us that we have to find the differences or the similarities between the prepositions like over, across, under, and beneath, right? This is something that you gave yesterday to me. I know. I would request all our friends over here to find out the answers for that. And you can cross-check your findings with the help of the post-training reading material.
So till now, we have seen that prepositions help us to identify an object and locate it in its surrounding.
Jeannie of articles, I think it's been long time since I visited you. I thought, let me pay a visit to you. How are you?
Hi, Jeannie of prepositions. It is nice to see you after so long. Would you like to take a tour around my world of articles?
Sure, Jeannie of articles.
Come, let me introduce you to famous articles in my world. Meet my first article. This is Miss Anne. She is the most finicky of the three articles. She is a kind-hearted article just as the other two, but is a bit choosy. If you are a word and if you want to make friends with her, you better start with a vowel.
Oh, that's nice. Hello, Miss Anne.
Yeah. She actually likes to hang around with words that start with vowels. And going with her popularity among vowels, she is also the chairman of the Vowel Association. Now meet Mr. A. Mr. A is an always trending celebrity among the biggest group in the world, which is the group of consonants. If you are among those millions of words which start with a consonant, then he is your guy to hang around with. Between Miss Anne and Mr. A, he is currently leading with the largest number of followers, all thanks to the huge number of words that start with consonants.
Hi, Mr. A.
Now meet Mr. The. Mr. The is the godfather of the articles and enjoys the utmost respect in the community of words. He is also one among the nicest gentlemen. He is such respected in the world that in order to make friends with him, you would need a recommendation letter from either A or Anne. If only you prove that you are friends with one of these two articles, that you are allowed to meet Mr. The. In the world of words, he is currently leading with the largest number of followers because both the followers of Mr. A and Anne actually follow Mr. The.
Hello, Mr. The. It was nice meeting you.
These three articles can be divided as definite and indefinite articles. A and an are the indefinite articles, and the is the definite article. When the indefinite articles A and an refer to something, they do not tell us specifically who they are referring to. But when the definite article the refers to something, it makes it very specific.
Jeannie of articles, I have got the watermelon for you. Should I be using the watermelon, a watermelon, or an watermelon?
Oh, first of all, that's very kind of you. But then let me tell you this. See, the indefinite article A is used for words starting with a consonant or a consonant sound, as in a cup, a watermelon, or a man, and so on. The indefinite article an is used before words that start with a vowel or a vowel sound, like an umbrella, an orange, an ant, and so on. But on the other hand, the definite article the is used to refer to the same object that A or an has already specified, like the cup, the watermelon, and so on.
Oh, that's nice. My friend, a teacher traveler, was looking for some activities. Before that, I also know that the Mr. The has some unique friends. Who are they?
Yes. So the unique friends of the that I was referring to are those unique and one of a kind items or things in this world which go specifically with the all the time. Just like the Taj Mahal, the universe, or the Himalayas, and so on.
Hey Jeannie, one of my friend is a teacher and wants some transaction ideas and activities, just like I asked you before, to teach articles in her classroom. Can you share some ideas that I can go back and deliver to her?
Sure. Let us now go through some transaction ideas for articles so that you can give them to your teacher traveler, okay? So the first activity here that we have is a game called Teacher Says. This is taken from a famous game called Simon Says, which is pretty famous among the English teachers. So I'll tell you what happens in this game. The teacher gives instructions to the learners and the learners have to just follow them accordingly. For example, the teacher might say something like, "Teacher says, touch a bag." Then the learners should run and touch a bag. It can be actually any bag because remember the teacher has said, "Touch a bag," which is indefinite and which is not specific. So the learners are free to touch any bag. This activity actually makes learners listen to an instruction in English and react to it kinesthetically. The kinesthetic element of this activity makes it a fun activity for learners. Now that I have explained how this activity is transacted, let us play a game. I will ask a question now, and I request you, as well as all our teacher participants, to try to answer to it. Okay, here is the question, teachers. Please listen to it carefully. So in the next round of Teacher Says, the teacher instructs to all the learners. Teacher says, touch a nose. So Kashvi is also one of the learners in her classroom. Okay, and Kashvi wants help from us. Let us imagine that. So if you would have to help Kashvi, what would you suggest her do? What should Kashvi do now? Because teacher has said, touch a nose. What should Kashvi do? Should Kashvi touch her own nose? Or should Kashvi touch her friend's nose? Or either of the two? If you actually look at the instruction properly and concentrate on the article used, you will get to know that any of these options could be correct. Because remember, we have used an indefinite article and the teacher has not specified which nose or whose nose. So Kashvi is free to touch anybody's nose. It could be her own or it could be her friend's nose. Interesting, right?
Yes, Jeannie, it was a very interesting activity.
Now, let us recap
all that we have discussed about articles. So, articles are those special words which help us refer to things that we want to talk about in definite or indefinite way. Where the is the definite article and ye and an being the indefinite ones. Now we have reached our checkpoint of one. Jeannie, if I add the before United States of America and say the United States of America is a large country, is it right, Jeannie?
Yeah, that would be right.
Then if I add the before India and say that India is a large country, is it correct, Jeannie?
No, Nalini, that would be a wrong usage.
Then this is a nice little puzzle which made us to think. If we use the before United States of America, then why don't we use the when we refer to India?
Yes, this is surely a food for thought for us, isn't it? I know some of our participants might already know the answer to this, but to those who are curious about the answer, they can find it out themselves after this session. Try to find it out from any source that you can, or you can look for the answer in the post-reading material that will be shared with you after the session today.
P is reading, P is reading, P is reading.
Nalini, what are you saying?
P is reading.
Don't you think there is something wrong in the sentence?
I feel something wrong with this sentence, but I don't know what is wrong with this sentence.
Let me tell you, whenever we look at any sentence, we look for two important things in it. Do you know what are they?
Don't know, Jeannie.
Let me tell you, the two things that we look out in any sentence is a verb and a subject.
What is the verb and subject, Jeannie?
The verb in a sentence tells us what is happening in the sentence, whereas the subject gives us the information of who is doing that.
What are subject and verb in this sentence, Jeannie?
Nalini, in the sentence, we can see that it's the children who are doing the task and reading the book is the task that is going on. So the subject is we and reading is the verb. Let us come back to the sentence after we have discussed a bit more about what exactly is subject-verb agreement. Let us first go through some simple sentences and try to practice identifying the subject and the verb. At the same time, let us also try to figure out any hints or clues about what subject-verb agreement could mean. Nalini, here is your first sentence. It says, he is singing. Can you identify the subject and verb in this sentence for me?
I can identify he as the subject and singing as the verb.
Yes, you are right. Here comes your next sentence and it says, they are singing. Can you identify the subject and verb for me?
I can see that the subject here is they and the verb here is singing. But I notice that are is used in the sentence unlike the previous sentence where is was used.
Yes, Nalini. We will come back to this later. Okay. So here is your next sentence, and it says, the family is singing. Can you identify the subject and verb in the sentence for me?
The family is the subject, singing is the verb. I can see here, is used again with the family being the subject and singing being the verb. Curious.
Definitely. It is curious. Let us look at some other sentences and try to figure out the subject and the verb in the sentence, and also see whether they are in agreement or not. Here comes your first sentence, Nalini. It says, Rustam and Saharab is going trekking. Can you identify the subject and verb in this sentence?
Yes, Jeannie. Rustam and Saurabh are the subject and going trekking is the verb.
Yes, you're right, Nalini. Can you tell me whether the subject and the verb in the sentence are in agreement or not?
Jeannie, I don't know, Jeannie.
It's okay, Nalini. Here, the sentence lacks subject-verb agreement because of the use of is in the sentence. We use is for a singular subject. That sentence would be right if it read, Rustam is going trekking. But because we are talking about both Rustam and Saharab, we ought to use the plural helping verb are. And the sentence should be, Rustam and Saharab are going trekking. Did you understand?
Yes, Jeannie.
Here comes your next sentence. It says, a good book and a hammock is all the entertainment I need. Can you identify the subject and the verb in this sentence?
A good book and a hammock are the subject. All the entertainment I need is the verb.
Yes, you are right.
Then,
do you think the subject and the verb in this sentence are in agreement?
Yes, Jeannie. We had just discussed, if we are talking about plural subjects, then our helping verb needs to be plural as well. Is it correct, Jeannie?
Yes. So, I think there is something wrong in this sentence. Can you correct the sentence for me, Nalini?
The correct sentence would be, a good book and a hammock are all the entertainment I need.
Very good. You're absolutely right. Here comes your next sentence. It says, Malik like fish. Can you identify the subject and the verb in the sentence for me?
Malik is the subject, like is the verb.
Do you think the subject and the verb in this sentence are in agreement?
Jeannie, I don't know, Jeannie. Okay, our teacher friends are there. Dear teacher friends, I'll take your help. Do you think the subject and verb are in agreement in this sentence? Then what can be the correct sentence?
Nalini, I can see many of your friends have been answering as likes. They are telling that we should be using the word likes instead of the word like.
How it is likes?
See, whenever you have a subject, all you have to do is you have to see whether the subject is in third person singular. If it is in third person singular, you have to add yes to the verb. Therefore, the correct answer would be Malik likes fish. So here comes your next sentence, and it says, We enjoys horror movies. Can you identify the subject and verb in this sentence for me, Nalini?
We is the subject, enjoys is the verb. Jeannie, as we discussed, we is plural pronoun. So the verb needs to be
in. Okay, I think you are trying to tell me that we is the subject and enjoys is the verb.
Yes.
So just like we saw earlier, here we have a pronoun we and it is in the plural form. So we should not have yes added to our verb here. So the correct sentence would be, we enjoy horror movies. Nalini? I think Nalini is so bored answering me here. Sushil, can you help me out?
Yes, let me help you out. You can ask me questions. I'm very enthusiastic to answer.
Yes. Here comes your next question, Sushil. It says, either grandpa or my sisters are going to the park. Can you identify the subject and verb for me in the sentence?
I think both my sisters and grandpa are the subject here. And going to the park could be the verb?
Yes, you are right. But can you tell me whether the subject and the verb in the sentence are in agreement?
Now that I'm thinking of it, I think I need some help.
Definitely, Sushil. Let me ask our friends here to help you out. Dear teacher friends, can you help us out to answer whether the subject and the verb in the sentence are in agreement or not? Yes, they have been telling that the subject and the verb in the sentence are in agreement. Do you go with them, Sushi?
Yes. But how is it that the subject and the verb agree here?
Just as you can see, we have two subject here. Whenever you have two or more subject, all you have to do is look at the subject which is closer to the verb. Here, the subject that is closer to the verb going is my sisters, and it is plural. So whenever we have a plural subject which is closer to the verb, you have to use the plural form of the verb or a plural form of the helping verb. Therefore, either grandpa or my sisters are going to the park is a correct sentence. Just like that, I have one more question to you, Sushi. It says, either my sisters or my grandpa is going to the park. Can you tell me whether the subject and the verb in this sentence are in agreement?
Looking at the sentence, I would say sisters and grandpa being the subjects and them being a plural subject, I think it should have been are there instead of is. But going by what you have just taught me, that the nearest subject makes all the change in the sentence, then looking at grandpa being a singular subject, I think the use of is correct. So either my sisters or grandpa is going to the park, I think there is subject verb agreement in this, and I think the sentence is correct.
Yes, you're absolutely right. Now, let us go back to the sentence with which Nalini started. Initially, she was saying, we is reading. But as we have gone through now, I think, Nalini, can you tell me whether the sentence, what would be the correct sentence to this?
Yes, Jeannie, I know the correct sentence. Here, we is the subject and is the verb. But we is plural pronoun. So we need to be use are. So the correct sentence is we are reading.
Yes, you are right.
Nalini, would you like to know some of the activities regarding subject verb agreement?
Yes, Jenny. Now I learned subject and verb agreement, but I want some more activities for my classroom. Can you help me?
Sure, Nalini. What can you see here?
I can see here a train.
Yes, the name of this train is Samjhota Express. Do you know what Samjhota means?
Samjhota means agreement. This is clever. Samjhota Express for subject and verb agreement.
Yes, you are right. Here, the learners will hop from one box to another, and when they are in each box, the teacher reads them a sentence. Learners should then identify if the subject and the verb in the sentence are in agreement or not. Then they have to answer accordingly to the teacher. If the answer is wrong, then they have to step backward. If the answer is right, they will be hopping forward. This is one idea where the learners take part in kinesthetic activity and learning language.
This is an enthusiastic activity, Jeannie.
Yes, come. Let me tell you about another interesting activity. This activity has lot of visual elements in it. Can you see a grid with some numbers here?
Yes, Jeannie, there are numbers.
Yes, all you have to do is the learners will give the right answers relating to singular helping verb or plural form of helping verb, and then use colors and numbers to complete a drawing. Can you tell me, if I ask you what dash your phone number, what will you answer?
Is. What yeah. is your number?
Yes, you are absolutely right. Can you tell me what is the color that is associated with the word is?
The color is brown.
Yes. So all you have to do is wherever you find number one in the grid, you have to fill those boxes with color brown. Same way, you have one more question which says, who dash those people? What would you answer here, Nalini?
Are. Who are those people? Which is in green color.
Yes, you are right. So what will you do, Nalini?
I will put green color in the boxes which has number two.
Yes, you are right. Same way, you will be filling out the complete picture. And after filling it out, what will you find?
I can find a tree.
Yes, you will get a tree after you color all the grid.
Wow, this is a colorful activity, Jeannie.
Yes, it is. If and only if the learners get the answers right, can they color the right boxes and reveal the hidden colorful image?
Thank you, Jeannie.
So regarding subject verb agreement, the aspects that we have discussed so far are, we need to look out for three elements to make a sentence right. The first is look at the subject of that sentence. Then look at what the subject is doing. That is the verb or the helping verb. And then look at how many of those subjects are present in that sentence to make your subject and the verb agree. I thank all the genies and all the teacher travelers who have collected interesting activities as well as shared interesting activities on the following topics of tenses, prepositions, articles, and subject verb agreement. My dear teacher participants, I hope you all have enjoyed equally all the concepts and all the activities. Now let us talk about some serious matter. All the activities and all the concepts that we have been discussing so far, and we have been listening to people discuss so far, are connected with these LOs. These are the learning outcomes that these activities, starting from grade 4, 5th, 6th, and 7th, actually cater to. So if any of these activities are transacted in our classrooms, you will be fulfilling either of these learning outcomes. These are the list of the chapters, grade-wise, which each of the concept connects to or corresponds to. So regarding tenses, we have activities, or the activities that we discussed so far can be connected to the to these chapters from our textbooks, which we can actually utilize and transact in the classrooms, thus supplementing these chapters. Same with the concepts of articles and subject verb agreement.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Idinada resource persons, Srimati Uma Madam Auru, Nalini Madam Auru, Kriti Matte Sushil Auru, tenses, articles, matte prepositions bagge tumba chenagi onduvare gante kaladavarege namge tilisikotru tumba dhanyavada. Pritiya shikshaka snehitare, modalne tarabeti illige muktayagutte. Ellarigu namaskara.